got, what the? Janet Love? Hey! Janet Love?
Oh, it's almost done.
Hold on. Janet Love, what is this? What is this creation? What do we got going on right now?
We got some organic chicken breasts, mm-hmm. some organic broccoli, mm-hmm. and I had some leftover bok choy mm-hmm. in the fridge, so I just threw it in there for our greens. Mm-hmm. And I just kind of made up the sauce a little bit with mm-hmm. some dark mushroom soy sauce, mm-hmm. and I added a little fish sauce, and I seasoned the chicken with mm-hmm. some garlic and onions.
Okay, we got a meal.
Yes.
We got a little meal. We got the vibe.
It with some organic white rice. Look,
let me see. Where is that?
Asian rice cooker, right?
Okay,
here.
Okay.
I've had this for years.
Okay. Hey, look.
Hey, it's actually done. Oh, it's hot.
It's popping right now. Okay.
Yes, it's ready.
Yeah, we eating good. We eating good. Hey, we eating good. Hey, hey, yo.
Mukbang video.
Come on, let's go. They're not ready.
Yes, they are.
Let's go.
Hello, welcome friends, so family. Welcome to my YouTube channel.
Hey, yo.
Welcome to another non-traditional mukbang video.
Non-traditional.
I am Janet Love, and I'm so honored to introduce you again. Jordan has already been my guest. Lucero already has been my guest, my soul sister, my soul brother over here. Yo. So Jordan Walker and Lucero Rodriguez.
Hola.
Hola, hola. Wow.
Yeah, we're back at it again.
Yes.
About to be a new year.
Yes.
In like, what, 1.5 days? What's today? The 29th? 30th?
Today is the 29th.
Yeah.
Yes. Tomorrow's the 30th.
We ain't got time.
We have another day, 2 days, a day and a half.
Then we out.
Yeah.
2023, that's it.
Yep. So guys, really quick.
Yes.
We already had the cameras on. So I made organic chicken. If you guys can see, little sriracha sauce on top. Organic chicken breast with broccoli and bok choy and onions and garlic. We just kind of whipped it together and did a stir fry.
She did a thing. Okay.
We were talking about going out somewhere, and we got Chinese food like, what, a week ago?
Yeah.
We went to Jerry's. And remember, we got the orange chicken, and it was like super fried.
It was not good, yeah.
Yeah.
Yikes.
And my tummy hurt. So,
the orange chicken you got before was way better, which was like a month or two ago.
Yeah.
Dang. And Janet cooks all organic and with a lot of love. So.
It's her name.
And it didn't even take that long.
It's like 90% organic. Yeah, it was really quick.
They chopped the garlic and the onions.
Yes, my sous chef.
You know, put a little work.
I made the rice.
Yes.
You went crazy with that rice.
He did an incredible job with the garlic and the onion.
But his eyes.
It looked amazing.
He was crying the whole time.
I had to put my face in the freezer. Y'all didn't even notice.
Crying out of gratitude.
My whole face was in the freezer for like 5 minutes.
Freeze your face a little bit. Anti-aging.
Why are we doing it after?
Well, you know what we need to do? We need to get a bowl of ice and dip our face in it.
A bowl of ice?
Yeah, I feel like doing cold plunges.
But for her face.
We'll
do this. It's going to be in the bloopers after.
No bloopers. No, we want, you can, if you guys have never done that before, you guys get to try it. Big bowl of water and put ice cubes in there and then dip your face in there. It's supposed to like close your pores, shrink your face a little bit. It's just good for your face. There's so many benefits.
Just sounds like a cold shower.
It's kind of like a cold plunge.
A cold what? Plunge?
A cold plunge.
Oh, yeah.
You know how people do the cold plunges with the ice bath?
Yeah, when they're just in the whole tub and they just jump in?
Yeah, but they don't jump in, but
But they just slowly. Yeah. You did that before?
Yes, I have actually. At the spa.
The cold plunges. I love those.
Yeah, I did.
You did that before too.
It was so cold. Freezing. I felt it to my bones.
I'm feeling it right now. Yeah.
Okay, let's ground, guys. We're gonna eat, okay? So with love, we're gonna bless the food. Who wants to say a little prayer?
I guess I will.
Me?
I felt like I had to because
we always
nobody volunteered.
Give gratitude and prayer over food so we can nourish our bodies. So go ahead, do your thing, Jordan.
Okay. Thank you from the
heavens above, for, you know, bringing us all together and making these moments the best moments. It's all about the small things, you know. So I'm very appreciative of this life and what is to come and what is happening right now, because we're living in the present, and that's what it's all about. So thank you for these blessings. Thank you for this food, and thank you for this great energy, and thank you for all these opportunities, and we're just going to be grateful right here and right now. Amen.
We are grateful. Amen. Thank you, Jordan, for the prayer. Thank you. May this food nourish our booties.
Amen.
Amen.
And our brain.
Amen.
And our hearts. And my toes.
Yay. So wait, really quick, I want to show you guys this goddess dress that my girl bought for me, my sister over here, and she's wearing one too. It looks so hot on her.
It is Athena.
With this print. We met a girl named Flower. She's the one who designed all this. And I was eyeing this dress, but I didn't want to buy it. But then my sister bought
it. She totally got us you because she said, "What's your favorite goddess?" And I'm like, "Athena." And she's like, "I got something for you."
The perfect dress.
Mm-hmm.
And she said it was love at first sight when she saw the dress.
Yeah.
It has to be a thing. It has to be love at first sight, truly.
Yeah,
truly.
Yeah,
it's not real.
No, not it's real. Not.
It was at a night market. It was at a night market where we went 16, dancing 40. The other night.
Yeah.
It was just...
16,
I'm so glad we went out.
It was too
I'm so glad we went out.
Yeah.
For sure.
That was a good night.
I didn't want to either.
Us.
I was like...
Hey, and Carlos...
No, we were screaming, "Let's go!" I think it was me. Yeah, it was me, Derek, and Carlos. And Carlos just randomly showed up at your house. You didn't even know he was coming.
Well, I went on FaceTime with him. He told me he was coming, I guess, but I didn't hear it. I don't know.
I heard it when he
you
said
did?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I guess
yeah.
I missed that part somehow.
Yeah, yeah, we
connected.
Used our inspiration skills.
Cheers to water. Did you guys know that you guys can raise the vibration of your water by telling it, "I love you, I love you, I love you, I love you, I love you. May this water heal my body. Heal my body. I love you, I love you."
You can tell it jokes.
May this water make us laugh.
It'll make you laugh.
May this water bless my body, hydrate my body, and detox my body. Yum, 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 yum.
And we also have rose. It's like a rose concentrate, and it promotes.
Water.
It's one of the highest frequencies. This is the Bulgarian rose,
mm-hmm.
and it
mm-hmm.
promotes healthy digestive system. Helps you, your body to detoxify, balances your energy level, improves your mood, freshens breath, creates a sense of well-being, and it also connects people to their heart,
mm-hmm.
and it eases their mind. It has so many benefits.
We got that at Sprouts.
Yeah, this one we got it at Erewhon.
Oh, Erewhon, that's right. Mm. And roses are the highest frequency of love.
Oh.
And it's really good to drink rose, spray rose, give roses.
Sit next to someone.
That's why I love doing rose blessings.
Oh, yes, and she got me flowers.
Roses,
too.
I do purification and cleansing of the white roses and the red roses as well.
Mmm.
Yeah.
Mm. It smells great. Oh my gosh.
What do you guys think?
You're a chef.
Chicken.
You're a chef, for sure.
Right?
You're a chef.
What did you have with her the first time?
What did we eat last time?
Mm.
I know we had rice and something.
It was chicken thighs.
Chicken thighs?
Lemongrass chicken thighs.
Lemongrass.
Mm-hmm.
That was fire too.
I go back to the video and watch your video.
I licked the plate for sure.
And I love this yellow bird hot sauce. Very clean ingredients. I did forget my pre-controlled capsule meals and the enzyme pills. But it's okay. I usually take those. Not every single time. I don't remember every single time, but but I usually like to take these pre-meal capsules from the superfood company that we're brand partners with.
Oh, yeah, that little...
Oh, no.
What?
The battery.
Okay.
I think before it dies, I probably should switch the battery.
You have another battery?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, we'll be right back, y'all, after these.
Let me pause it. Dance while you eat. Hey. I'm coming in with the camera. Go, Jordan! this hottie over here. Look at our crystal grid. How cute is that?
So what were we talking about?
We were talking about,
Bulgarian rose water.
How good my food is.
Healthy sriracha. There is such a thing.
Yes.
Organic eating.
Yes. So we were at the grocery store. Mm-hmm. And Jordan was grabbing the things, grocery shopping. Hey, Jordan is a handsome dude and he's trying to have gains.
Yeah.
But he was grabbing foods.
That technically you would get gains, but shopping with Janet, you're not getting that shit. Like, it's not gonna happen.
He was grabbing Pop Tarts and you put it back though, right? Yeah. I was like, no. I used to love Pop Tarts as a kid. Oh my god, did you eat Pop Tarts? As a kid? Pop Tarts is pretty fire.
Yeah.
But knowing like the food industry and how bad the food is nowadays, I just would not put that in my body.
Yeah.
There is actually healthy Pop Tarts. It's at Whole Foods.
Oh, really?
I forget the brand, but I've seen it.
No, I've had
it's
it cleaner.
The ones without the fuss.
Yeah, it's
organic.
Toaster strudels.
But it's so good.
Strudels?
Toaster strudels.
I loved toaster strudels. I was obsessed with it, but it's so unhealthy.
What? I thought that was the healthy brand, no?
I wish.
No, I gotta take you to Whole Foods. We're gonna go grocery shopping, and we're gonna do a video.
Okay, I'm down.
And then
and y'all gonna see me get scolded. Y'all gonna see me get scolded. Maybe we should go to Walmart first.
No.
And we can see if I'm conscious enough to know what is good for me. And then
I feel like Air One would be a little better though, because Whole Foods has like a lot of allegations towards it.
That's true.
For what?
Like that they're getting a lot of their food and stuff from China.
Well, there's many different brands, but like I'd love to go to Whole Foods for did my chips to see if their brand is really good. And just making sure, because we love to snack. So making sure it's made from avocado oil and coconut oil.
We do love to
But snack. There are some brands that obviously don't have the integrity of being clean and organic. And what a lot of people don't know is a lot of the oils are processed and it's highly inflammatory. And it's making people gain weight. And we don't want that. It causes inflammations.
Yeah, we don't.
We don't want that. We want to
no more Pop Tarts.
Feel good. That's the key. Especially going into 2024, guys.
Yeah.
How was your 2023, though? We can touch on a little bit of 2023.
What I got to say about 2023.
This year.
I feel like I've, Have I succeeded?
On any goals or anything you've accomplished. So what have you accomplished in 2023?
What have I accomplished? The main thing and the most important thing that I have accomplished, and I feel like is perhaps the most important thing that you should accomplish in your life, is to be one with yourself and know yourself and understand yourself and be comfortable with yourself, okay?
Be one with yourself.
You have to be one with yourself and
can't
understand.
Be two with myself. Three.
No.
How do you be one with yourself?
How do you be one with yourself? You just let everything happen the way it's supposed to happen. You let it come to you. You don't try to force it, alright? You don't try. If something doesn't work
out.
So
I'm thinking flow.
We're flowing. We're going with the motion. And we know and understand that the things that we want, I mean, are already inside of you, but in the things that we want to achieve, like let's say like one day you want to have this nice car or one day you want to have this nice house, like we're not going to stress about those kind of things.
No.
Okay, because it's going to happen, right? It's going to happen one way or another. You know, you have these visions in your mind for a reason. They're placed in your mind for a reason.
So it sounds like you're not limited.
Yeah.
You know you're going to get what you want.
And we know our worth, okay? We know what we're worth. So we're not settling for anything.
Do we?
We're not. We do. We better.
Now
we do. We better.
Yes.
It's been a journey. We do.
It's been a journey.
Yeah.
It's been a journey. And, you know, going through life, sometimes we forget our worth. And that's okay, and that's a natural thing. But you gotta bring it right back around and tap into who you really are. And people will see. And the people who are gonna be in your life are going to appreciate your value and show you how valuable you are mm-hmm. and make you feel valuable.
That's what we're calling in for 2024.
Yeah.
So,
be one with yourself.
mm-hmm. I'm creating value, honoring mm-hmm. our value, mm-hmm. and not limiting.
We're not selling out for nothing. We're not limiting ourselves. We're not selling out. And mm-hmm. yeah, we're
this is what a lot of people is working through, though, their self worth. So it's it can be very challenging for some people to create something for themselves, like create their priceless or a relationship they're in, you know, that's not serving them. There's so many things that could have blocked people, you know, and they're, mm-hmm. This is why healing is so important and why we need to shed those things, those belief systems that might have been said to us or taught to us by our parents, by our grandparents, just energetic, ancestral things that doesn't serve, that's more of the negative aspect of frequency. Yeah. And I feel like since a lot of us are becoming a lot more aware and spiritual, mm-hmm. we are ascending and we are learning mm-hmm. and we're shedding those layers. To grow and elevate, to really trust and surrender that we are abundant. We are always going to be taken care of no matter what.
Yep.
We don't have to worry about the crap, you know, like not having enough, like a roof over our head or a nice car or food on our tables.
Yeah.
But we're always abundant, right? But right now, I know I'm striving for success, and I know I am succeeding when I can support myself with financial freedom in the way that, like, my money's working for me, mm-hmm. and I can make money while I'm sleeping. Well, to become healthier mentally, spiritually, and physically, like, that's very important to me. And when I can support somebody with that, that warms my soul. Like, I would love to support you in grocery shopping and support you in just feeling better in your body, period. Because you're an amazing dancer. You have a lot of energy naturally, but damn.
But damn, them Pop-Tarts.
Lucy just discovered his dancing, and they were totally vibing the other night dancing. I thought that was beautiful. You know, and sometimes I don't even want to go out to the clubs anymore because the energy feels heavy and all that, but I'm glad we went out the other night because we just got to, like, not let that bother us and just really
enjoy. You gotta be
enjoy.
With your people.
But I know.
That's what it's about, your tribe.
You're my peoples.
I'm your peoples.
I know.
Okay?
And you're a total vibe.
We are a village, okay? We roll together. It's about your peoples, okay? You are who you hang with.
Yes.
Okay, so if you're hanging with grumpy and moody people, well, it's gonna rub off on you. It's gonna be in your chromosomes. And you don't want that, okay? You're gonna feed off that. Mm-hmm. We're not dealing with that. And I could get a little more psychological.
Unless they want.
What? Unless they want it. They don't want it, though. That's the thing. They don't want that. Nobody wants that. Who would want that? We all want the same thing, right? What do
we
all
want? I think it just depends in our background, though. Like, if people are used to it, mm-hmm. like hanging out, like if people grew up with addicts or people that, like,
it just depends.
Sell drugs, mm-hmm. you know, it's going to be, like, a really, it depends on the vibration and the intention behind everybody that's doing it, right? But, like, yeah. I grew up with a lot of addiction, so there was people that I hung out with mm-hmm. because I just love people, mm-hmm. and it wasn't the kindest people.
Yeah.
I thought, like, I just endured it, mm-hmm. or even being in toxic relationships where I was like, oh yeah, this is not a big deal, mm-hmm. but realizing that I'm like, oh no, this is actually, like, totally.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So, like, finding, like, real people with love and that are willing to heal or as free as you dancing, mm-hmm. it's like, yes,
yeah.
I was looking at you earlier and I'm like, you're a dancer prayer. In many ways, truly, authentically,
aww.
Your heart.
Aww, an answered prayer, is that?
Yeah,
aww,
for sure.
Beautiful, but what do you mean by that?
Because of, like
prayers
his,
from many?
No, like his
or?
Smile and his freedom and his self-expression, right? Like, it's not like the evil, like, closed you down in any type of way. Uh-huh. I feel like you were just able to, like, stay authentic to your heart. So like when you were
he's
saying,
a real one.
Yeah, when he was saying
like
you and when he was saying about like be
forever,
one with yourself,
forever.
He totally is one with himself. Like
yes,
oh. he is, it's embodiment.
He is
so.
Thank you very much.
Is this the Leo in you?
I guess you know. I mean, that's always been the goal. And you just, when you are, you know, and I'm not saying, like, I got everything down, because I still battle my battles in my head.
We all do.
You know, it's a natural thing. Mm-hmm. But mm-hmm. at the end of the day, understanding that it's a natural thing, because we have our mood swings, you know, something may happen, it might make us feel, but when you understand that
triggered.
This
you
is,
might get triggered.
Yeah, when you understand that this is a natural, like, all throughout your life, you're going to go through these ups and downs, but when you understand that's just a part of life, you're not going to feel as much heaviness mm-hmm. on the circumstance, because you know, like, okay, yeah, this, you understand all of this is going to pass, okay, everything is temporary, you know?
Yes, what's so, important is now.
The right now.
Presence.
Right now.
Presence. And I practice
choosing
presence.
The right people.
Choosing
practice
right people.
Presence every day.
Every
being
day.
In my body and just focus and do my best to put away my phone, you know, and be present with people.
Exactly.
But hey, being an entrepreneur, I can't say that. Being an entrepreneur, sometimes I get I can get distracted easily with my phone and answering to people, feeling like I have to answer to people all the time.
Yeah.
And it's okay.
It's okay.
It's okay.
That's fine.
It's okay. But that phone sometimes do get exhausting.
Yeah,
exhausting.
Exhausting.
Yeah.
Sure.
Yeah. I've been getting messages to wear the blue light blocking glasses. Mm-hmm. I'm like, okay, that makes sense.
Oh my god, I have a pair. I need to use it.
Yeah.
Wait, what is it?
It's glasses that have like a special type of lens that supports in blocking the blue light. Mm-hmm. Because the blue light is what like tells the brain like to wake up.
Okay.
And certain ones.
You can take away melatonin.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. If you're on your phone before you go to bed and just staring at your phone in the dark, it's going to deplete your melatonin. It's going to be harder for you to sleep.
Yeah,
and
even
speaking with
the phone in the
same
room.
Yeah, I've heard about
from
that.
The radiation, our 5G network nowadays.
Oh, jeez.
Oh, my goodness. I know.
You got
that. So, guys, if you are on your phone a lot or your laptop, computer, watch TV.
Calm down.
Try it.
It's
getting
okay.
into nature sometimes.
Yeah.
Take a walk, step away from the phone.
When you're on
and
your
don't
phone.
Put your phone in your pocket for the guys right next to your you homies. And for the women, like some women put it like their phones like in their pocket of their breast or their armpit. Like that's like the worst.
The worst place
to put your
phones. Be careful.
Or anywhere on your body.
Yeah, right.
So even like having like sacred geometry, like a little fanny pack with
or an organite.
Sacred geometry.
Mm-hmm. Or crystal, organite crystal. It can balance the
separate.
Radiation.
Yeah.
Yeah, it can neutralize
mm-hmm.
the energy of the radiation from the that's given the phone's given off.
Absolutely.
Wait, so let's get back to 2023. What same question.
You're asking me?
Yes.
Mm. 2023 was
how was it for
exhilarating.
You?
Was,
what have you accomplished?
I was living by myself for a while, which was a big deal
mm-hmm.
because I always lived with
yes.
a partner or I lived with my family.
Mm-hmm.
So having my own space
mm-hmm.
was so liberating.
Nice.
And
that's amazing.
Yes. Even though there was a lot of lessons behind that, especially like getting out of like codependency and continuing like my to grow my business. I have an energy healing business.
You had a furnished apartment too. I thought that was really nice.
Yeah, I did have a furnished apartment with pool and jacuzzi and beautiful trees with hawks. It was wonderful. It was magic. Yeah, I was in love with it.
So nice.
And I'm about to move. But that was really amazing having my own place and having a lot of clients there as well.
Yeah, she's in transition right now, but she's been my sister wife this past couple weeks. And it's been very nice to have her here.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And with I had a health scare a few months ago, and when I have my own business and I'm not working, like, money's not coming in. So that was really difficult for me
mm-hmm.
because to realize, like, to be a mother and also be, like, having my own business and not getting, like, a steady paycheck, there's a part of me that's like, oh, okay, like, this is this is where I get to ask for support. So luckily I had a beautiful girlfriend open up her home in Malibu, so I was there for a while. Like she mentioned, I'm a sister wife here. And it's great because we have each other. She works out a lot in the mornings. I've been doing a lot of yoga, which is great. Yeah. I feel like, yeah, I've been really active. So meeting amazing people. And yeah, and I also got hired at this amazing center. I've told you both about it.
My biggest
dream is that, like, to open up a healing center in San Diego. And this place is an art healing center where they have natural doctors, chiropractors, intuitive healers like myself. So that has been amazing. And I feel like rather than talking about some of the shitty parts of 2023, because there was a lot of those.
I'm focusing on
what's really amazing. Because I've definitely focused on things that have happened that take my energy away from, like, the things that are really beautiful and wonderful. Like, I've given too much attention to, like, the sadness or something, and it's like, what we pay attention to, like, that's where our energy goes, right?
Absolutely.
So, I'm celebrating the Healing Art Center, and I move into my new space on January 1st. I'll be gardening for the first time.
You can garden with me.
Oh, like
Read them.
And the mountains are literally right there.
Teach me how to garden.
No, but I made a friend, Sarah, and she does landscape, and she said that she'll teach me.
So cool.
So those are
highlights. Are you
going to
get seconds?
I will be getting seconds.
Anyways, I'll share a little bit about my...
And one more thing. With my baby girl. She's four and a half.
She is
the most amazing present and gift of the world. It's so fun to have her. And co-parenting is not easy. And also, there's a lot of forgiveness in co-parenting.
A lot of patience.
So many tears.
Yeah.
But
Rhea's so bright and beautiful.
She's so cute. She's
adorable.
Really cool.
Wait a minute. You guys gotta check out.
I
got a mukbang video with her. YouTube video with Rhea.
Disconnected.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
iPhone 5 disconnected. But yes, you guys gotta check out the mukbang video with Rhea. It's so cute. We were eating noodles together. Organic. We got the food from Hope. Thai food.
So yeah.
Oh my god. Jordan has never tried Thai food.
We're about to turn him on to
mukbang.
We almost went today, but we're like, you know what? We get to save money, eat organic, cleaner than going out to eat because not a lot of restaurants are organic.
Another mukbang coming.
Another mukbang coming right up.
Yeah.
Guys, I'm working on my intro and outro, but I'm building my YouTube channel now, so please stick with me. I'm doing my best with working on my consistency, and I definitely would love to just build and create more videos. So my intention is to inspire and educate and just teach the ways of better health, for wellness, for our mental space, our spiritual space, and our physical space. So all the things and more lifestyle, period.
Here.
Healthy, holistic lifestyle. Okay, so really quick, my 2023 was very stressful. I felt like there was a lot of sadness, but I feel like something to celebrate, honestly, is my whole year of celibacy. That's something to celebrate. Like, I've really been doing the inner work on myself that I'm actually really proud of myself that I haven't, you know, been dating or anything like that, which I'm totally okay with because it's my choice, and this is where the energy of it is. But I chose to be celibate for a whole year just to cleanse and clear and really heal myself and take care of myself before I move on to even dating or thinking about, like, a relationship. And next year is going to be a whole brand new year, so we'll see what's coming.
Okay.
Yeah.
Look at you.
Yes. I'm very proud of myself to start the YouTube channel. I think that's something to celebrate because I've been talking about doing it for a very long time and I haven't done it until recently, and I've been a little bit more consistent on creating videos and, you know, bringing
the videos to the audience that get to hear our story and share what we go through. That way, you know, you guys can relate to us or not, you know, or just learn from, and that's it, really.
Look,
are you okay?
At you. Contact is bothering me.
Oh no, do you need to go to?
It's okay.
I have contact solution.
I'm gonna get that real
okay,
quick.
Okay, in my restroom.
Okay.
Okay.
Hey y'all.
BRB. Jordan will be right back. But then I would love to touch on our 2024. I'm really excited for the new year. Let me see. Is there anything else that I've accomplished? I'm calling in more clients, which is beautiful for Reiki healing.
Emily, any type of dance routines?
I've been dancing. I felt like I should have been dancing more. But you know, I get to be more consistent with taking more dance classes.
Mm-hmm.
But I did get hired to dance for new artists, so that was really exciting. I've gone through some breakthroughs with that itself, and then the show ended up getting canceled, which I was really sad about. That was a huge thing for me. I realized that I went through some limited beliefs through not being a good enough dancer, and I mean, I just get to practice. It's really all about the practice, just like my yoga. I get to practice and keep that
or energy healing.
Yeah, and energy healing. Yeah.
Yeah, I think energy healing is one of the the most amazing types of training.
Mm-hmm.
And we're about to teach a certification for Holy Fire Reiki February 9th and 10th in Calabasas and
Westlake Calabasas.
Mm-hmm. And so I'm at the Altadena Healing Arts Center as well. And with energy healing, just like everything, it takes passion. If it's like it speaks to you, to your heart, to your body, to your spirit, it's a learning process. And I was looking at the manual, reviewing it to prepare for the classes. And there's something new all the time. There's something new about like the stories in Japan about Master Yusui.
I have a video
not that great.
I have a video with Lucy talking about Reiki healing, so you guys gotta check that out. But can you just explain really quick in a nutshell what energy healing is? And for the audience that don't know what it is.
Oh yeah, of course. So the simplest and most awesome way that I like explaining it is that the body's like a river.
Mm.
So when we are born, our river is flowing really well.
Yes.
And throughout time, there is like little pebbles that start to get stuck. Eventually, it can become a little boulder, which eventually can become physical disease or something intense. Like, so what energy healing does through prayer, through invoking our ancestors, through honoring the land, through sacred geometry, through the teachings of other teachers, energy healing awakens the river back up, starts removing those little pebbles, the bigger pebbles, which is, it could be emotional blockages, physical or spiritual. So it's returning back to the most authentic self. And some souls do come with certain karma, so that also helps ancestral healing as well, especially the sacred geometry. I think that that's one of the most forgotten arts, or that hasn't been taught in Raider school districts.
I love the flower of life, Metatron's cube, all the beautiful sacred geometry. Do you know about sacred geometry, honey?
No. Are you okay?
I'm okay. Sacred geometry? No, not aware.
Oh my gosh, I gotta show you the.
Wait a minute, is that when you, when I first met you and you drew that thing? And it was like a love, calling in love, right?
Yeah, it's
I remember that.
Invocation of love.
Yeah, I remember that. I didn't know what was going on, but
I was
like,
you just channeled that symbol, though, right?
No, it was actually from the manual.
Oh.
And it was next to a temple, next to a deity.
Oh.
So it was in the mountain that Master Yusui discovered Reiki, or he got the big download.
Beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
I know. We meditated in the car today before we went into Target with the Sophia Code and the Dragon Force energy, the Golden Dragon. And I'm excited to get my dragon tattoo for protection.
And I'm excited to learn about a deeper level of the Sophia code.
Oh yeah, I need to look into that a little bit more.
How's your eye?
It's okay.
I need contact solution in the other bathroom.
Okay. So 2024, guys, what are you guys going to create? What are you guys going to manifest? What's your vision? What do you see for yourself? What do you guys see for yourself? I should write some prompt questions.
For myself, my intention is to create a deeper connection with God, a deeper connection to nature, to take people that have been out of touch with nature back into nature. So having people to meet me at one of my favorite trails at Mount Tina.
We should do a Reiki circle in nature.
Yeah, I would love that. And since I'm working at the center Monday and Friday, I'm thinking about taking people on Monday mornings to hike out there to the waterfalls. I'd love to take you.
I would love to.
Yeah.
Are you kidding me? I've never seen a waterfall in my life.
What?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
I've never seen a waterfall.
We're going right now. Yes. We're getting
Let's
in the
go.
Car. We're going
Let's
to a waterfall.
Go.
Oh my god, I can't.
I would just want to take you to Yosemite.
I want to go to Yosemite. Are you kidding me?
It's seriously one of the most magical spaces. The first time I went, I'm like, I'm not leaving.
I swear that would be me. I
swear. I'm like, I'm not leaving.
I
left because I was afraid.
I'm always that guy. When I discover something new and a new experience, I'm like, oh, I'm not going. I'm going home, back to my life? What?
No.
But yeah, I'm open to
the trees.
Or,
the trees.
Are you guys excited for 2024?
I'm excited because life is going to keep lifing. Keep on elevating.
So that means we're going to keep dancing.
We're going to keep
through
dancing. Yes.
Through it all.
There's so much that we are going to experience and we don't even know. We don't even know what's coming, but there's just the mystery behind it is so, what's the word? Help somebody. The mystery behind all these great experiences is so something that has to do with your heart and
it's expensive?
No.
Discovery.
No.
Reconnection.
No. It's very
falling in love again.
I wish I could think of this basic word. But yes, it's like intense. Okay, the thrill! It's
the
very
thrill.
Thrilling!
Oh.
It's very thrilling!
You heard that.
It's
right
very
right
thrilling!
Now.
It is, we are. Listen, no. We are excited for the ride, okay? We are excited for the ride, okay? Alright? Oh no.
Oh my god, you spilled
water.
It's just water. We'll wash the carpet.
Sorry.
It's rose water. It's like a blessing, actually. It's a blessing to the carpet.
Love roses.
This is good for you, too.
Yeah, she did a woman's circle with her. No, because of the audio.
Oh, no. It's a little chilly. Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, the purification?
Yes.
Yes.
Purification.
So when I went to the Altadena Healing Arts Center and I was meditating in the office, it's such a peaceful place and there's no 5G, so there's no, like, Wi-Fi. People can have their phone and stuff, but you could just tell that
there's
it's really
Wi-Fi
protected.
In there? Oh wow!
I know. I was like, what? It's such a healing vortex that.
Too much.
Okay, now, you were talking about Altadena, the healing center.
Oh yeah, it's like a peaceful portal there, and I heard to create a purification circle with white roses because the white rose supports in cleaning the auric fields for people. And purifying as well. And it's a high frequency. So even though I was nervous about it because I only had a week to like promote it or tell people about it, there was this nervousness to it. And I'm so glad that I followed through.
Yes.
Because
it
was
amazing.
Like I had really high, valuable women in there, women that needed to be heard, to be seen, to be spoken,
to more
so much love into one another, and it was truly one of the most magical moments.
Done eating?
I think so. I was actually, when you were cooking, every time you were cooking and you leave, I go and I would pick out something.
Oh.
So I think I'm full.
No.
I think I'm full.
It's so crazy I didn't eat chicken for like 7-8 years and I just started eating meat again.
It's the Zaz.
It's nobody's fault. I think it's after doing ayahuasca, I chose to be pescatarian and just kind of support it. Because when I was in Peru for 5 weeks, I just was on a vegetarian diet. And we did eat eggs, but I didn't eat any animal meat besides eggs.
Wow. What?
That was fine.
A ticket to Burning Man again, you know, like I'm so blessed to be able to go to Burning Man, so that's something
I
like,
am so grateful that I finally went to Burning Man.
Yes, something like that, for example, you know. And Thailand, Vietnam. I definitely want to go to Vietnam
for my car,
and I definitely want to go to Japan.
Yes.
So I'm being called to go to Japan.
You are called.
Her
ancestors came in. Yes, I'm going to Japan.
It.
My family's
moving.
My family's moving.
I know.
My family's moving to
Japan. I will go
to Japan
eventually.
You will come to Japan and we'll all plan it out.
Bucket list.
We got a place.
I've been to Japan airports. And I left the airport and like got some ramen like outside of the airport somewhere.
You know,
and
we need to walk the streets
But
of Tokyo.
I need to go to Tokyo.
That's what I'm saying. We need to walk the streets and have
the
pool.
I get to go to Tokyo. We get to
and
go to Tokyo.
And show them how we get down in North Hollywood.
Yes.
They're not ready, okay?
I can picture you with North Hollywood shirts on.
Yes! And they're going to think we're the coolest people, too. They're going to think we're so cool.
When I used to live in Chicago, I had this guy I was dating at the time. He used to call me Hollywood, too. Or actually, a couple of my friends have called me Hollywood.
Oh, what
so
the heck?
Hollywood.
Dang it. Derek called me that yesterday.
Oh, really?
Yeah, he said.
No one's ever called me Hollywood.
Might as well be called this.
I had a few nicknames. He called me Little Ninja. And then I have a girlfriend that calls me Little Dumpling. Do you guys have nicknames? Little reward your friends call you like little cute names.
Oh my gosh. Cute names? It wasn't that cute. He called me Lumpy.
Lumpy?
That's
Lumpy? Are you Lumpy?
What is
Lumpy
that
where?
Because my brother hit me in the head with a vacuum cleaner.
What the
fuck? I'm okay. But then, you know, like when Tom and Jerry, like when I get hit and then the thing grows, something had hit it when he did that. A lump grew. I'm okay now. It went down.
It went down.
I think.
You're good.
I have so much hair, you can't even tell. But yeah, that was my cute nickname. Lumpy.
You're so blessed.
Lumpy.
That you have
so you took Lumpy. You answer to Lumpy. So if
I don't answer to Lumpy. Don't call me that.
Lumpy.
Don't call me Lumpy. Don't call me Lumpy, okay? Oh, wait. Jordy. That's my.
Jordy.
Yeah, that's
okay.
That's my little nickname.
He doesn't remember. Okay.
Jordy.
So we can call you Jordy.
We'll call you Jordy.
Well,
first.
My little. I call them my sisters, but my little cousins. Mm-hmm. They call me Jordy. Yeah. So.
Okay. What about you, Penny?
Well, my name is Lucero, so people call me Lucy.
I love Lucy. Everybody loves Lucy.
Lucy. I mean, my grandma used to call me Estrellita or Lucecita.
Lucecita. Lucecita.
Lucecita.
What was the first?
first one is the who?
Estrellita.
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 What is that?
Star.
I feel like this light is so bright for some reason.
Yeah.
I should warm this light up.
Oh man. I wish we had heaters.
Yeah.
It's so cold.
Oh, there you go. What a difference. Mm-hmm. Oh my god.
Would you like this jacket?
Yeah. Like,
okay, so 2024, guys. 2024.
2024. All I'm worried about is really nothing.
What are you manifesting?
What am I manifesting? The greatest year. It's gonna be the greatest year. I don't know how it's
gonna
I
adore you because I truly authentically hear you speaking from your heart.
Oh.
So
yeah.
It's like, oh yeah, I'm not worried about it either.
Wait, you? Or
yeah.
Are you just saying me?
No,
yeah,
I'm not
about
worried
you?
About it either.
Oh
like,
yeah.
It's like I was.
I think
but
this
being
comes
around
to trust.
You to be like
it's
yeah.
trusting.
And
right?
certain people
yeah.
have surrendered. Put in front of me, they're trusting.
Yeah. I don't know
yeah.
what's gonna happen. I'm not forcing
my
anything,
intention.
But it's just going to flow and it's going to happen the way it's going to happen. And we're going to enjoy it. The ups and the downs, you know. And that may sound very cliche,
the ups and the downs.
But it's very
more
real.
More ups than downs.
More ups than downs. But I will say this.
But
be
grateful for the downs.
I'm going to say this, though. We're going to be so great. And that's all I know. We're going to be so great. I don't know how it's going to happen, but we are your business.
Booming.
Booming, okay?
Your
business,
business?
Come on,
booming.
Booming, okay?
Booming.
My business,
booming!
Stop playing, okay? I don't know how it's gonna happen, but it's going to happen, okay? I don't know,
it's
and I'm not worried.
You're gonna create it.
Well, I'm gonna create it. I don't
yeah,
know how,
it's action,
but
no,
it's gonna come down from above, and it's gonna hit me, and then y'all gonna see how everything
unravels,
okay? All right. And one thing about me, I'm a big visionary.
Yeah.
I have big dreams, and I mean, that's why I moved here by myself.
Yes.
And
but
I came here.
An action taker, too.
I'm an action taker. Mm-hmm. So I came here to make things happen. I mean, I see myself just being the greatest person that I can be.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I don't have to be the greatest performer.
Mm.
I don't have to be the greatest entertainer, but I'm going to be in the industry, and I love it, and I'm going to be so
industry.
Great. The entertainment industry, music and acting
kind
and
of.
Writing. I'm a writer too, I'm a director, you know, yeah, I just, I'm not worried. It's going to happen when it happens, and we're not going to worry, because when you worry about things, it takes life away. You're not living your life.
So, what are you saying? Like, you usually never worry. Is that it's
oh.
like that's something that you learned from your mom?
I
you naturally kept because
oh my God. My mom
there's
said,
a Reiki teaching that says a Reiki precept. Just for today, I want to
worry.
and the just for today is to keep us in the present moment.
Oh, yeah.
That I'm very curious about you
how it happened with me.
Because I would like to say the same thing.
Oh yeah. that would happen. Well, I mean, like I said, when we were talking earlier, like, I tap into my childhood feelings as a kid. You was never worried really about
inner
anything.
Inner child, yes.
And you didn't, have to have the greatest things. You wasn't worried
oh
about having all this materialistic stuff. Like,
right.
You know, you would make fun just at a playground. I mean, I know personally. I mean,
it's
kids
the
do
outside
that.
World.
Yeah, you use your
yeah.
imagination. And you don't have to have too much, you know? Like, kids nowadays, you know, they have these tablets and these phones and stuff. Like, when I was growing up, you know, we just used action figures. I don't even know if kids really play with toys like that. But it's about using their imagination. Oh, yeah.
Well, I have a little one, so...
Yeah. Okay.
But,
okay.
Yes, I could see that.
But a lot of kids
difference.
These days, they're
yeah.
like, you know, they're more so on the TikTok and on the Instagram. And I'm talking like I'm a grandpa. But listen, but that's real stuff, though.
Yeah.
So, but my point is, it's all about imagination, and imagination is whatever's put in your head. Like, y'all can't see what I see. I can't see what you see. I can't see what you see. But you see it. You see it for a reason, and you feel it. You said that you feel good when you help people. You said you feel great when you help me grocery shop. You know, that's your feeling. That's your vision. And perhaps that is the mission for you. It keeps you going. It keeps you alive, that feeling.
Mm-hmm.
Same with you. With
energy healing.
The energy healing. Yeah. Do you feel like, I don't know, do you feel excited, like, just thinking about, like, opening? Because you said you want to open up a clinic, right?
Yes, the healing center.
How does that make you feel when you think about just getting to that point?
Fulfilled.
Fulfilled.
Fulfilled because there's going to be such a large group of people supporting, mm-hmm. like, natural doctors. And yeah. the mission is to support families
yeah.
in their wellness and their mm-hmm. freedom and their imagination. Like mm-hmm. you're saying, like our mm-hmm. imagination has been under attack for so long
yeah.
that it's so amazing to like meet you and realize that it's so alive for you.
It's so alive.
Just like the way it is for like kids.
Yeah. You know?
And it's, so I've been visualizing it and like the universe is giving me what I want. Mm-hmm. And there was a part of me that was like, I can't wait to get there. But realizing that it's okay to like enjoy the process so much. Yeah. Interesting and interesting.
This is another thing that yeah. I've learned too. Man, I used to overlook this like in TV shows and in movies. But basically, if you're not happy right now, or I'm going to say, yeah, if you're not grateful, because happiness is just, it's an emotion that can fluctuate. You're not always going to be happy. You know, you mm-hmm. have your bad days.
Yeah.
But if you're not grateful for what you have now, then when you do get the things that you think that you really, really want, it's really not going to make a difference. Because you're going to, I mean, you just have to be grounded and in present right now. You have to mm-hmm. know that how you are right now and whatever's going on, what you have right now, you have everything that you need. You literally do. You don't
I
need
really
more.
Do.
Well, it, the thing, it. Also, I agree with you like 1,100%.
Mm.
Or 1,000%. Mm. Somebody was like, you know what, like, there's never more than 100%, but that's mm-hmm. just one perspective, right?
Mm.
People but, always want more.
Yeah.
People always, and naturally, you, as humans, yeah.
And you think about presence, though, but mm-hmm. with trauma,
mm-hmm.
there's so many people, including myself, that it takes deep discipline
mm-hmm.
to be 100% present in our body,
oh,
in my body.
Yeah, no, it takes work for sure.
Yeah.
This was an overnight.
Yeah.
And I'm still working on it.
Yeah.
I'm still working on it, but, you know, it's just, it's a process and it's a journey and it's just, it's a feeling too. You definitely have to just keep on just trying to feel this feeling of gratefulness like I have.
Gratitude every day.
That I need.
Gratitude journal.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Do you have a gratitude journal?
I have one. Ooh. Yes, I have one. You know what? I don't use it often, but I will tell you this. I write down my feelings a lot.
Mm-hmm.
Especially if I'm feeling like confused or angry at something, I'm going to write down and I'm going to question myself, why am I feeling like this?
Mm-hmm.
You know, elaborate.
Love that.
You know,
how long have you been doing that?
Oh, maybe, maybe about a year.
Wow.
Yeah, probably for about a year, a little longer. Mm-hmm. And it helps you get to know yourself and triggers.
Mm-hmm.
And, yeah, so, I don't know, I'm just very all about being expressive.
Yeah.
And,
you could do videos too, record yourself.
Yeah.
And watch yourself talk.
Yeah.
Paris taught me that.
I guess
Paris is like, you should watch yourself talk.
That's a good idea.
I've done that a couple times to get to know myself. It's
yeah.
kind of tricky.
And then you go back
yeah,
and listen.
So trippy.
Yeah. Or mirror work.
I cannot usually like watch myself talk in videos.
Yeah.
But I'm getting better at it.
This
is why I created this channel too. It's like I feel so much better with camera presence because I never wanted to look at myself on camera before.
Yeah.
But now I'm like, this is not so bad.
Not so bad,
I'm
you know?
Used to it.
You're
it's
natural.
Like dipping your toes in the bathtub and then
exactly.
Like,
yeah. One step at a time, just
you
a
know,
little
you
bit.
You just ease in. So
mm-hmm.
yeah, but we're just trying to be grateful. And
so
it is something that you have to work towards like understanding and
but
coming.
Yeah, and setting the intention.
And setting
because
the intention
is everything, right?
Yeah.
So like
mm-hmm.
being compassionate with yourself, like realizing, like asking yourself like some tough questions, like am I present with myself?
Mm-hmm.
Am I numbing?
Yes.
Am I
mm-hmm.
avoiding? Or also am I celebrating myself?
Mm-hmm.
There could be so
mm-hmm.
many questions, but being honest with yourself about your state of presence.
The power of intention.
Honestly.
Yeah.
It's
and
such a good book, The Power of Intention.
And understand your feelings
yes.
are going to fluctuate. I'm not saying by all means you're always going to feel positive because you're not.
Mm-hmm.
You're not. It's impossible.
you're gonna feel down, you know? You're gonna feel, sometimes you're gonna feel just like not really trusting the process some days. And these are natural things too. That is also part of the process, is going through the negative phases too, which a lot of people don't accept or talk about. Like, you're going to feel some days like you're not gonna feel it. You're not even gonna wanna talk some days, but that's just, it's like, it's all,
yeah,
it's all part of the plan.
I feel like that really speaks to my heart, because there was a moment where I was doing my best to do everything on my own, to mm-hmm. be like, I'm independent, mm-hmm. I got this. Mm-hmm. And there was a moment where I burnt out.
Yeah.
And realizing though, like, it, those were really tough moments, but they opened up to this kind of moment, to be like, let myself be supported and loved by my sister. Mm-hmm. Because like, having my own apartment by myself, or like with a little girl, I'm like, wait, like, who am I? I love talking to her, but yeah. it's also like, wait a minute, So like, when there's like,
and just keeping it going too, yeah. like day after day after day.
Yeah, being single mom is challenging. Of course,
totally
understand. I hear from all my single mom friends.
Then being like, oh, I'm an entrepreneur. I'm like,
Hey, but moms out there are doing it.
They're single moms, and they're freaking doing it.
They're working.
Like, best person in the world. I can definitely tell with your daughter. Like, she's so sweet.
Mm-hmm.
She's so sweet.
She is so sweet. I love that girl.
I love that you say that, because a couple of my girlfriends, when they met her, like, one of my girlfriends that passed away, is still sister Marisa.
Yeah.
She told me the first time she met Rhea, she's like, I didn't really want a baby, but seeing your baby, like, I want a baby.
And you're so sweet, too. Like, I heard the way you talk to her, and, like, you're just, I don't know, I can just tell, like, you're a good mom. For
Thank you.
You're a good mom. Like,
thank you.
You're, like, best friends.
Yeah. I can definitely
Well, that's what I didn't want to work for somebody else, like, especially having her and being a co-parent. I only have her, like, half the week, because we decided to share her time. And I didn't want to be working. Like, I wanted to go walking with her, talk to her, play with
her,
kiss her for hours. Mm-hmm. Like, we would wake up and we were like little cuddle monkeys, mm-hmm. or pterodactyls, mm-hmm. or some kind of wild animal, and we would just like kiss each other's nose. And or sometimes I wouldn't want to wake up and she would just be staring at me, and she'd be like, "Mom," and I'd be like, And the wake up call, which Janet has heard me say, like, she'll be like, "Mom, come wipe my butt." And I was like, "Okay, I'm getting up. I feel like there was a part of me that was mad at myself, because I wanted to be the super successful entrepreneur.
Yeah.
And then there was another part of me that's like, I want to give my daughter all my time. And as long as that there's a roof over my head and organic food on the table, mm-hmm. it felt so satisfying.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Not knowing that, like, not saving money mm-hmm. is, like...
I love that you said organic food, because...
100%.
Moms don't know how to feed their kids.
They don't know, like, so you said. Classic. Like, all the advertisement, like, I hardly watch TV.
Yeah.
But there was, like, moments, I don't know, I would go somewhere, and there was actual commercials, and I hardly ever watch things with commercials, but they're like still advertising hot Cheetos, like, oh, there's a blender for your hot Cheetos, so you could put it on top of your mac and cheese. I was a hot Cheeto addict.
Even I wouldn't.
Honestly.
Really?
I'm right.
But they advertise these like things that are like, or they're still advertising Tide, which is not exactly like the healthiest detergent to be wearing.
Oh,
anyway, so
literally everything is bad for you nowadays. Seriously, even
well, not
our paper
everything.
Cups. Even our paper cups. There's
a lot of
things
that are good for us, but it's about learning what's out there.
Yeah.
Everything.
And that's what we're doing every day.
And it's not doomsday. There's a lot of hope and there's a lot of faith. It's just about willing to change. Willing to shift.
And
I'm
choose.
Open to a new
Making
world.
Better choices.
I'm open
it's
to a healthier way of living and being. Affirmations,
and,
right?
Yeah, and I choose a better lifestyle. I choose to put better things in my body.
Yeah.
Don't worry,
choose.
I got you.
Please, thank you so much. I appreciate you. Sincerely.
It's really wonderful to see that, like, you're open. And that's the thing, too, because I realized when I started learning about superfoods through Alicia, that she Jenna introduced me to. Mm-hmm. She's like, oh my god. She's like, do you know anything about parasite cleansing? And I was like, no. She's like, you're supposed to do it like 4 times a year. And I just didn't want to know that we had like parasites inside of us. I'm like, I don't want to know this.
If we're eating meat, sushi, we have parasites.
There's so many other things.
Oh, so many things.
But, and at the same time, like, knowing, I think, like, I would, myself, I had little, like, panic attacks here and there because I'm like, oh, no, like, I ate, like, shit most of my life, you know? Making the shift is what matters because it's not gonna, like, we're so resilient as humans that it's not to make anybody wrong for their choices or, like, yeah, it is a little sad that people are selling.
People are not educated, you know? That's all it is. It's programming. People are not educated. We used to watch those crazy-ass commercials growing up in the 80s, 90s. Coca-Cola, cigarettes, you know, milk, cow milk, all these things. Aunt Jemima. Which one?
I'm so sad about Aunt Jemima.
What was
Aunt Jemima the syrup?
Yeah.
Oh. I never thought she was syrup. Dirty.
She's dirty?
She's dirty. Oh. Well, no, they like something about the name, like that somebody stole the name, or I don't know, there's a weird story with Aunt Jemima, but like that, it's like, it's not good for us, like it's a really harmful type of sugar, right, that spikes the insulin.
Yikes.
So,
yes.
So knowing stuff like that, I was like, ah, like, and seeing it everywhere, I'm like, oh no, oh no, I know, and then
following me.
Realizing it though, one of the best things from Kentucky, was I went to go pee, and I looked at a book next to me, and it was called The Art of Living. And it said that the world has always been a beautiful mess, and that our only job is to take care of our mess, and that, like, to take care of our peace. Mm-hmm. And I actually got a tattoo of it.
Oh, yeah?
Oh, the world is a beautiful mess.
Beautiful mess.
And I feel like that taught me a lot, because it's, like, so easy to like promote something or say, like, wanting to save. For me, I wanted to save everyone and I love everybody else. And I realized that I'm like, oh, okay, I get to tend to my body and make those shifts myself as I'm teaching. But it made me panic less about saving people.
Yeah.
And I'm like, oh, okay, like, they're all resilient people.
Yes.
God has them.
Yeah, for sure.
More than anything.
Yeah.
So things can shift and humanity can make different choices.
Exactly. Yes, absolutely.
And you can't save anybody too until
they want to save themselves.
Well, I was going to say, you've heard it. You can't pour into somebody's glass if yours is empty. Mm-hmm. Or, yeah. You got to be good with yourself too before
take
you
care
can help
of yourself.
Anybody else.
Fill your cup up first.
Yeah, fill your cup up first, and then
it's like the airplane analogy. You have to put your mask on first.
Before you can help somebody else.
Exactly.
Out, yeah.
You have to put your mask on first.
It's not gonna work out. It really can't. So.
Yeah. So 2024.
2024. We're just going with it, and we're just being confident that it's gonna work the way it's supposed to work, and we're gonna be good. We're gonna be good.
According to numerology as well, 2024 adds up to an 8. So 2 plus 0 plus 2 plus 4 equals an 8. And 8 is such an abundant number according to numerology. So I believe that this coming year is gonna be amazing for everyone. It's gonna be a huge shift for people who've been stressed out. Maybe no job, no this, no that. You know, like all the things that have made them sad. I think the energy of next year is going to be so uplifting.
It's going to be so uplifting. I feel it. I also want to mention, and I think I already said this, there still will be adversity that we're going to have to face.
Oh my goodness.
Nature
calls.
It builds you up, and that's okay. So,
did you hear about the little tsunami that happened in Ventura Beach?
What?
It was intense to see. And it was
small. Oh my god, I'll show you. It was a
Ventura?
Small, yes, which is like an hour away.
No, I didn't see this.
I gotta show you.
When did this happen?
Wow. Yeah, like two days ago.
Tsunami?
Like a
little one. But it was still, like, still it moved scary. Cars, it still swept, like, people, like.
Oh, I don't know.
Yeah.
So, guys.
guys, take care of the earth. Please pray for the earth.
Pray for
our Mother Earth. Pray for your families. Mm-hmm. And pray for protection. Pray for safety. Because we all have spirit guides. And our angels are there to support us and guide us. But they want you to talk to them.
Talk to them.
Do you talk to your guides?
Yeah, I do. I stepped out outside. I don't know who I was talking to, but I was just talking. And I was just like,
help me out, please.
Thanks, you know, thanks.
Yeah, you got me.
You got me. Yeah, and a great way to pray for the earth is to go outside and like touch the ground. And like with your whole heart, with your whole essence, like you can blow, you can sing, you can dance, you can dedicate that energy for the earth. She wants for the ocean.
Mm-hmm. She wants to be plants, recognized. Roses.
Yeah.
You can take roses and bless the land and bless the earth. Mm-hmm. Oh, and for women who gets their periods, their cycle, you can bleed into the earth too. That can balance the earth's feminine, divine feminine, and it's a whole history about it. I'm not gonna get into all that right now because I get to read that story still, but what I've heard is that, you know, it's been a man, you know how it's been a man's world, war, all the things, so I know Jordan is like, leave me out of this conversation.
No, I'm listening. I'm intrigued. I'm like,
So we can, there are women that do ceremonies and they collect their blood from their menstrual cycle and give it to back to the earth, to the land, to bless the land. And it blesses the plants, the land, the earth. And yeah, I think it makes it happy.
Recognized as sacred.
Mm-hmm. It's our sacred blood. And I think the history is because there was a lot of war and murders and a lot of people dying, you know, in the past. Now still, of course, but like having our sacred blood where because we bleed for 3 to 5 days and we don't die. So for us to be able to collect that blood and having the earth receive it, it can give it energy. And we basically just bless it. Mm-hmm. Period.
Imagine if the whole world.
All the women, ooh. It's like the whole world meditating together. Ooh, wow.
I love that.
Wow.
We need this video to go viral.
Wow. I love your imagination.
Yeah, just like...
Your
just
prayer.
Yes. Thank you for that.
Yeah.
Guys, can you imagine all the women gather together and bless the earth that way? Or, period, both the feminine and the divine masculine. Divine feminine, divine masculine. Millions of us meditating together at the same time.
Let's do a live stream.
Wow.
And
I mean, we do the 144 thing. Have you heard of that meditation for 144? 144 1,000 people should meditate together at the same time because that raises the vibration as well. And I think there is a thing. People are already doing that. But can you imagine millions? Wow.
Yes.
Yeah.
Wow. Collective consciousness. This is kind of like the 100 monkey story or something. Have you guys heard of the 100 monkey story?
Yes, but you can remind me.
I think it has to do with food. I don't remember it clearly, but when one monkey was hungry, I think it had to do with a potato. And a monkey was trying to figure out how to eat a potato or something. Mm-hmm. I need to Google it. Let's see.
A monkey's trying to eat a potato? Is that what you said?
It's a 100 monkey story. Let me see. This video is going way longer than expected, by the way, because we have so much to talk about.
We have so much to talk about. And it's all good. So a monkey was eating a potato. So go back to Makaka. They was in Makaka Futata.
The Japanese snow monkey, Makaka Futata, was kept under observation for over 30 years in the year 1952 on the island of Kishoma. A group of scientists provided a group of monkeys with sweet potatoes covered in sand. The monkeys liked the taste of the sweet potatoes but found the dirt unpleasant. An 18-month-old female monkey found a solution. She washed the potatoes in the nearby stream and shared her discovery with her mother. She also taught it to her playmates, who further showed it to their mothers. This cultural discovery was eventually being picked up by many monkeys. At least such was the observation gained by the scientists between 1952 and 1958. Almost all of the young monkeys had learned to wash the sandy sweet potatoes. Only the adults who imitated their children learned this social improvement. Other adults continued to eat dirty sweet potatoes. Then a startling phenomenon was observed. In 1958, a certain number of Kishima monkeys were washing sweet potatoes. The exact number is not known, but the assumption was that if at dawn of a particular day, 99 monkeys knew about washing the potatoes, then by dusk of the same day, 100 monkeys knew. And by that evening, almost everyone in the tribe was washing sweet potatoes before eating them. Then added the energy of the 100 monkeys somehow created an ideological breakthrough. Another exemplary fact observed by the scientists was the journey of this knowledge overseas. So basically the colony of monkeys on the other island and the mainland droop of monkeys began washing sweet potatoes too!
on the other island?
Yes!
Okay.
So it's a collective consciousness.
But did they do
the
same?
They channeled it. So they just learned on their own somehow. It's like getting a download. So monkeys get downloads too.
But what if the monkeys on the other island? What if the other monkeys were like, this shit's nasty too. Let me go wash them. That's probably what happened.
Are you questioning the theory?
I'm questioning the monkeys. Yes.
The hypothesis was then drawn when a certain critical number achieves an awareness. So it's just like an ideology of the word. It's a theory, right? I think it's a great story, though.
I kind of believe it, though.
This new awareness can be communicated through mental energy.
Wait a minute. Yes. So this theory is, if somebody thinks of something, then another person can have the same thought. Is this what we're concluding?
Collective consciousness. No,
I don't think we're concluding.
What are you pointing at?
I was about to make a point, but like, I was just, that's my hand gesture. Okay, because the other day,
we should get some ice cream.
You want some ice cream?
No,
yes.
Dessert.
You should.
Yes, please.
This is a long freaking video, by the way. It's been like over an hour. Okay, the other day.
Lessons learned.
Wait, listen.
What? Lessons learned. What?
The other day, I had fallen asleep. And I was thinking about sushi. And I was like, okay, I'm going to take care.
You've been thinking about sushi.
Was you thinking about sushi?
I always think
about sushi. The monkey theory! Huh?
I always think about sushi.
Oh, okay.
There's like telepathy. I think it's also telepathy in a way.
No. But I did not say a word about this stuff to Derek, okay? I'm laying in bed, and I'm like, okay, I'm about to go take him to get sushi. And I don't even know if this man likes sushi or not.
Okay.
I have no idea. Uh-huh. And then he just turns around and is like, hey, bro, let's go get some sushi. I said, what the fuck?
Oh, he read your mind.
I said, what? You like sushi? I was literally about to utter the words, and he beat me to it.
Yeah,
oh my goodness.
Come over here.
I was like, what?
Wait, there's only a couple more paragraphs.
Oh, go ahead.
Okay, so it says, lessons learned. Here lies a point over which even a single addition of a new awareness can significantly strengthen the field of awareness to the extent that it is picked up by almost everyone within a short period. When a certain number achieves an awareness, the new awareness may be communicated from mind to mind. See? Which is...
Are you thinking what I'm thinking?
Mind to mind.
Wait.
The new awareness may be communicated from mind to mind.
Uh-huh.
Okay, so the 100 monkey phenomenon points out our responsibility and our power.
Uh-huh.
We are affected by lack of harmony of any type anywhere on the planet, even if not consciously aware of it. So you guys know each other since 5 years old.
Okay.
I think that helped.
Yeah. Okay, I might have something to do with it. Wait, it says we're affected by lack of harmony.
Exactly. Being
you
one.
You guys are in harmony. You and your homie are in harmony because you guys know each other's vibe.
Perhaps.
And the monkeys are in harmony because they're all connected.
They're monkeys.
They're connected. We're all human beings. We're all connected.
We are connected.
And it's kind of like, but there are times when I think of you in like seconds, you'll call me. You know what I mean? Or text me. I'll be like, oh my God, I was just thinking
but
about
a
you.
A lot of people think we're sisters because we're together a lot. Because
we are sisters.
Like, yeah, we are. And
we've lived many thousands of years together. Many lifetimes.
Our souls have danced many dances.
I do believe this.
So, yes. The 100th monkey theory.
I remember another time I've had a monkey effect.
Oh.
When I was a kid. It's, yeah.
I'm pretty sure you guys can relate. I'm pretty sure you
We've
guys
all had
those
monkey
moments.
I don't mean
moments.
To be yawning, but I'm yawning.
Okay.
My apologies.
It's okay.
Wait.
So y'all learned about the monkeys. Y'all
already
the
100
know.
Monkey theories. We're completing
all
our 2024.
On a high note.
Yes, on a high note.
Yes, to the best year ever.
Really, we just want to bless you guys with a beautiful, amazing year.
Blessings.
You know, just let go and release this past year.
Stop worrying, okay?
Stay present in the power of now. Don't worry too much about the future, but take action on your manifestation.
Reiki
your
precept.
Goals.
Just for today, I will not worry.
Just for today, I will not worry.
Yeah, so there's 5 original Reiki precepts. Just for today, I will not worry. Just for today, I will not anger. Just for today, I will be kind to every living being.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Just for today, I will do my work honestly. And just for today, I will have gratitude. Mm-hmm.
Which means it should be every single day.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Or practicing staying in the present moment. So just for today or just for tonight. We will have ice cream.
And just a quick reminder for those of you who journal and would love to journal, just journal a beautiful gratitude list for what you want to happen, like it already happened, though. Like it already happened, so pretending, imagining that it already happened and pretending like it's December 31st, 2024, and you're journaling about your gratitude list on everything that you wanted to happen. We get to do that.
Tonight and tomorrow.
And that's it. Any last inspirational words for the audience today, guys?
Yeah.
I am speaking as if I was in 2024 already. And I am saying I am grateful for the open mics that I have attended.
Mm-hmm.
Where I
open
have given
mics.
Life
mm-hmm.
and received God's messages through me and blessed my brothers and sisters.
Whoa.
Yes.
And I am grateful for having the most amazing relationships and friendships that I've ever had in my life. And
I'm so grateful for good
the
friendship.
Dancing. Mm-hmm. All the dancing.
All the dancing. So,
all the present love.
Do I have anything to say?
Yeah.
Do I? I feel like I said a lot.
Mm-hmm. More to come.
More to come. Hopefully, y'all gonna take this home and you know, stay blessed.
Yes.
Stay
if you guys
blessed.
Watched all the way till the end, please dropped 2024 in the comments. Thank you very much. Please subscribe to my channel. More to come. And I love you all. Blessing you guys with a beautiful, blessed rest of the year. And a beautiful 2024.
Happy
New Year.
Happy New Year's, y'all. Peace, love, and hair.